Hallo, herzlich willkommen hier auf der Premierenfeier auf dem Axopar und Bravos Stand. Bevor es gleich hier losgeht, Sie haben ja schon gesehen, wir streamen gerade live hier der Tom mit einem Stick über den Stand, dass man ein Gefühl kriegt, was hier eigentlich los ist. Unheimlich viele Leute. Tag auf 2023 sind wir super stolz drauf und der Tom geht einmal über den Stand, bevor wir dann gleich hier auf das Highlight auf dem Bravo-Stand rübergehen. Wir beginnen nochmal einen kurzen Standrundgang, hinten die Axopar 22 Jovi, gefolgt von der 37 Santor Bravos Line, von der 37 Cross Cabin 45 mit Aft Cabin jetzt, dann haben wir die 25 mit Evoy, die 28 T-Top, dann gefolgt von der 28 Cabin. Und dann geht es hier schon auf die Brabus-Seite mit der Brabus 300, mit der 900 Signature Edition Black Ops. Und dann auf der linken Seite hier, das ist jetzt gleich 900 in Stealth Green. Die Jungs sind immer sehr gut in spannenden Namen und das wird man auch gleich sehen, warum die den spannenden Namen Stealth Green hat. Und jetzt schalten wir nochmal wieder auf den Stream. Bis gleich dann die Pressekonferenz von uns auch. Direkt der Konstantin und der Janne haben ein Mikrofon von uns. Das heißt, wir haben auch eine Kamera da unten und sie werden die gesamte Präsentation hautnah dabei sein und alle Details von uns direkt hier von der Messe für Sie nach Hause live gestreamt bekommen.
and welcome. I always love to start a press conference with something that shows that we are not only about boats, that we actually want to be a part and a close part of creating memories for our boaters and our fellow Aksaparians. Welcome everyone for the Aksapar and Brabus Marine press event here at the International Boat Show. 3 years has passed since the last time. Time flies fast. I'm Jan-Erik Viitala, the founding partner of Aksapar. Before we go into the products, I also want to take a few moments of dig a bit deeper what Aksapar is all about. So I'm going to tempt you with another video.
Leaving the shore and seeing a broader horizon is an electrifying sensation.
Ja, hier vorne liegen auch noch Backups, das nicht funktionieren sollte.
And we believe it should be accessible for everyone. We open new perspectives by bringing people out on the water. No matter how big or small their adventures are, they can be great explorers or curious minds ready to give boating a try.
That's why we make boats differently. Our innovative One Boat, One World concept stands for boats of great value that are multifunctional, easy to handle, and fuel efficient. Our exceptional yet user-friendly designs have been loved, questioned, and replicated. As the industry forerunner, we welcome ambitious competitors and even those who imitate when it's for the greater benefit.
you ready to step on board to discover new perspectives?
We are the Adventure Company.
Thank you. So, it's all about creating memories. It's all about being close to our loved customers, to listen closely to what they want from the future fleet of Axopars going in. It's all about passion. We've been saying this many times, and today I'm happy to announce our vision, creating the most inspired moments in life. Also, additionally, at the end of our mission video, you heard these words. Are you ready to step on board to discover new perspectives? This is actually way more than just some simple words. For Axopar, this is that we look at everything we do, from research, product development, redefining fuel efficiency, functionality, onboard comfort, production methods, methodology, modularization, all looked from a new perspective. But the key point with the new perspective is that we are here and we want to create more boaters and we want to attract more boaters into the industry. And everybody knows looking at a horizon, at a sunset from land, those who have boats, they know that that same sunset looks completely different when you're on a boat. So we're also challenging a bit the non-boaters to step on board, be curious. We will be here to assist and help you in getting you into boating. Additionally, what we want to do is take a small time to remember that only 3 years ago, we stood here in the exact position we are today, where we launched the Axopar 37, the second generation, together with the Shadow 900. So a quick recap that after this Corona struck and the whole world went in good and bad into a complete different scenario we were used to. But still, during this time, we managed to accomplish something. With the help and support and understanding of our fellow Axoparians, our dealer network all over the world, in order to keep production running together with our subcontractors. A quick question. How many of these Axopar 37s, the second generation, do you believe we have produced and built and delivered in the last 3 years? Take a quick guess. Any guesses? 200? 3,000?
That's a lot of boats.
500, 500, okay. So, we have produced, of the 37, today's date, 1,150 boats. And doing 1,150 boats of a 37-foot boat, I believe this takes us to be one of the top three in the world in making volume production on 37-foot boats. And for that, we are humbled and we are proud at the same time for this achievement, but we are also so grateful that so many Axoparians have found our brand. Another interesting fact, which we actually forgot a bit to celebrate, around Christmas last year, we also hit the 5,000th produced boat in the history of Axopar. We've done a lot of launches during these 3 years. We have a lot of launches here today as well. But if there is something I want to share, it's the Axopar 45. But as the boat is now on the other side of the container, we're going to do this launch a bit differently. But what's so special and why we love to talk with our customers about the Axopar 45, especially the cross cabin, is that it's a completely new generation and a new approach, a new perspective into fast and multifunctional commuters. an already innovative and a boat filled with features and functions have today got even bigger and even more. The standard layout of a traditional cabin boat has never really looked like this. So this is really a fusion between a sociable outdoor boat, but at the same time being a fully enclosed cabin boat. Today, we proudly present you the aft cabin version that is just situated 10 meters away from us. To get to know something more about that, let's use the help of our helpful dealer, Patrick Polsch, and have a look at the 45.
Hey, welcome here on the Axopar 45 on the 2023 Düsseldorf Boat Show. I'm sitting here on the unique piece of the Axopar 45 on the balcony door on the port side, which is an amazing place just to relax over the water. And now I'm getting over to Janne being on the front deck.
So what the Axopar 45 cross cabin is really all about is that we create so many versatile spaces on board where you can space yourself outside, enjoy the sun, the weather, or be fully enclosed, weather protected, wind protected, chill protected inside a very spacious and luxurious cabin.
And Janne just pointed out, it's all about being outside and inside at the same time. When I just went from the balcony door inside of the boat, I have an open side door, which I can just close up to be safe, or open it again towards the back, where it's more the way to the helm, for proper using at sea, like functional using.
Sociable seating for up to 8 people all around on the front cabin, facing forward, facing back, on the sunbed. But one thing that is my favorite is actually just being able to relax and lounge on top of the galloping doors.
Best place for me on an Axopar 45 is that it has an aft cabin as this one, is the huge sunbed on the back. Can you imagine? You could be lying here with up to 5-6 people next to each other and see what I can show you afterwards just going inside.
Following a lot of unique features are the galloping doors that we have standard on the 45 that really opens up the front cabin. So we have a full-size lounge inside here so that now when you're a full day out at the sun and sea, you can actually see some shelter. But what the galloping doors really do is really open up the whole front cabin, so the front cabin becomes one with the outdoors. So you will never feel secluded once you're spending time in the front cabin.
So what is below this big sunbed? You can't imagine, just come in. This is the biggest cabin I've ever been in on a sporty boat. And just, it's you outside here, having this big engine next to me,
but
like able to be looking up into the sky, just very impressive. Plus, we've got an extra storage in here, which could be also a small toilet then.
What is always important on an Axopar is that we have perfectly ergonomic helm position so that you can easily feel relaxed behind the steering wheel. You have a completely uncluttered view outside of the panoramic windows, and you can easily sit down, lean down, drive by standing, and you always have easy access all around the world. One thing you need also with the Axopar 45 is the dual sunroofs that we have. So if the weather turns bad, this is a whole weather commuter. Just close the sunroof, close the doors, close the back doors, and you're in a fully protected and closed mode, and this takes you like 10 seconds. Also another cool feature, we have 3 seating positions on the boat. We have very huge sliding doors, but also additionally, the wet bar now also acts as a leaning post. So you can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people comfortably facing forward while you're driving.
Hey, Janne, for being on the indoor boat show, I think there's enough about driving, so just show how we do that as a dining area. So just open the side here, thanks for the support.
Yeah, I help you out a bit.
I'm just flipping down the cushion here in the back.
They open the... So, yes, now we have a really sociable area for up to 8 people.
Very nice, and extremely nice view all the way out and all the air in with the sunroof open and the balcony doors open.
Yeah. The balconies to me is really something spectacular on this boat because we're still to remember we're on a cross cabin, we're on a fully enclosed cabin boat, all weather boat. So I don't see any other manufacturer doing any solutions like this. I would say we're pretty unique here.
I think you brought the inside to the outside or the outside to the inside, however you want to see it.
For sure. Actually, one more thing I want to showcase. So we have the wet bar in the middle position, now we have it in the back position. When I move the wet bar all the way forward, what it really is doing, it's opening up a new access way. So for me to just walk past you, Patrick, this is just like fully sociable, any day boating. where you actually don't feel cramped even if you have boat with doors.
One thing still about driving, how fast is this boat?
It's a 50 knot plus boat, so that is also in one way really, really spectacular and special.
And I can underline that because I've been using this boat several days in Mallorca or in the Balearics, and it's just amazing. We also having something very unique, an outside wet bar with a fridge, with a grill, and a small thing. And this would be all not worth anything if this beauty would have been ugly. Because this is like functionality, driving, this is all very important, but it still looks to, needs to be looking very nice, sportive, and state of the art.
Yeah. So if there's anything, I urge you to come and visit and have a look at the boat yourself. And actually spend some more minutes on board, because the more time you spend on board this boat, the more secrets, the more functionalities are revealed to you.
Absolutely. And thank you, Janne, for this amazing boat.
Yeah, cool. Thanks.
There you go, guys.
Nice thank you, Patrick, for that. So that's another way of doing a reveal. Going into an electrifying experience and something new coming out of Axopar. Axopar and Evoy, we are in love with each other in a way that we work together to push the frontier of electrified boating and push development together. So what we actually did, we brought one early stage one prototype into the Cannes International Yachting Festival in September last year. And we brought this boat to you to have a look at on our stand next to the 45. Just to get an overview how an early stage prototype is, and just to get an understanding of what we're doing together in order to make the possibility of electrifying boats, functional boats, into the future. What's unique with this is it's the first ever 300 plus horsepower electric outboard engine. And an outboard engine opens up so many different possibilities than shaft drives or other complex drives, because this is now a boat that you can beach, you have easier trailering, and you have easier storage. Shaft drives are usually something that you need to be a bit careful of. And again, with an outboard, trim it out of the water. It's never in contact with the water when you're not using it. Why do we do electric boats, you might ask? We see that there is a clientele. We can't say it yet if it's going to be 5% of our production or 10% of our production, but we will for sure have pioneers that already have electrified their homes, electrified their mobility, and now search for an opportunity to do this on the water. Today, we are still restricted by technology and battery size that will restrict range, and it will restrict also the weight and the possibilities to do. But being on the forefront and being pushing the boundaries of development further and further, we hope that we will be, when the technology is fully pledged and fully in production, that's going to be the moment where you will see some really interesting products rolling out from Axopar. What we are especially interested in and why we do the electrification on the Axopar 25 is that for us, an Axopar has always been about driving, about functionality, about seaworthiness and comfort while driving. And now, from our sea trials and our tests, we can easily say that we have taken none of these features and functionalities away from the 25. Now we have just added zero emissions and zero noise into the package. So you will get more information in the press kit, but we're running a Storm 300 horsepower outboard. It's an 800 volt system, so it's a high voltage system, and it's powered by two Chrysal batteries of 63 kilowatt hours each, so that we get a good functional range of 25 nautical miles. But running the 800 volt system actually changes the charging time so that we can charge from 0 to 80% in approximately 1 hour on a supercharger. And this creates the opportunity to, for example, leave Cannes International Boating Festival, drive the boat to Saint-Tropez, stay for lunch, and drive back. And this opens up, for the very first time, the possibilities to actually utilize and use a boat in this size range, even in open sea conditions. A bit irrelevant information, but still to me, our boats are always capable of high speed, but we want to make sure that the boats are safe also at the high speeds. Interestingly enough, and you will get more information about this later, the 50 knots is not something that you just push for a few seconds. The 50 knots is actually now, during our prototype testing, something that we can do for a pretty long time. So it's not only as a gimmick. This is actually, if somebody wants to travel 40 knots or 50 knots even, that's possible. But the magic comes from the 25 nautical miles at a average of 25 knots cruising speed. This is approximately the average range a boat club, a charter boat, or people going for commuting between their summer homes and their city homes, approximately what they will do on the max. So this opens up the possibility. Again, we have the boat on land, so let's take a quick video of how it went when we left Cannes on the last day on Sunday.
So the last minutes of the Cannes International Yachting Festival is really ongoing. I think it's 2 minutes until the horn blows, the show is over, it's a wrap. 6 absolutely amazing days here. A lot of customers coming on to the stands, having a look at what Axopar has on offer. And now, we're going to make a promise that we're going to take the Axopar 25 with the electric engine and drive the 25 nautical miles we promised this boat can do, and take it from Cannes into Saint-Tropez. So stay tuned, it's going to be an interesting ride. The horn blows, the Cannes boat show is officially over. Thank you for following. We've had a great time making all this incredible footage for you to follow for those who weren't able to come to the Cannes. Footage on our way over here. So what can I say? The early stage prototype deploy combined with an Axopar 25 really truly delivers what it promises. And when these boats are ready with the engines fully developed, it's going to be something
for euch on diesem Thema.
Thank you for following. We made it first.
So the boat, thank you. Some of you already had the opportunity to actually try the boat in Cannes. And well, we've been of course pushing the boats to the limits now in Norway, just to see how cold weather and harsh weather conditions affect the drivability. But what we're actually going to be doing during this summer and this season is that we're gonna have this boat fully available for the press to see, trial and test and evaluate, just to get an understanding of what we put in with the development work of creating this new electric boat. So at certain locations around the world, we will have the boat available, but this information will be revealed later on as we go with our event planning. Additionally, already was mentioned that there is a card that you receive in your press kit. It will have a QR code. All the video, all the press materials, even this video, we're recording this video actually at the moment. So all of that will be made available in this link so that you can utilize it for your press, and we will be updating additional pictures as well. Again, reminder, Mike and Adam will hand over the press kit over at the second container, and that we are also organizing a bit of a less formal press gathering on Monday the 23rd around 4:30 to 6, and we will have a possibility for Q&As. I know that today you are fully booked with engagements and you're running crazy, so we're saving this until Monday, so welcome to the stand. We're gonna be rewarding you a bit with the Ginnish fin, which has become a small custom on the Axopar stand. But going from a bit of playfulness into still something, I would say, a bit more serious. And if there's anything I want our colleagues, members of the press, you, our customers, to know something about us, how I started this press conference before we move over to Brabus and Brabus Marine, is our beliefs that we are following our passion for boating with courage. We have fun achieving this, and we don't deter from challenging ourselves time to time. But the one thing is that we are really looking at different perspectives of anything we do. And with that, we gain such a deep understanding of our production and how we can make the boats that it actually we're pushing to make even the most complex solutions work and actually not even be experienced as hard or complex. And of course, we enjoy being the forerunner to continuously push innovation. 2023 is going to be an interesting year. This is going to be probably the first year where we can actually start saying we're coming out of Corona. In terms of launches and the things we do today, that is interesting because that will build our company tomorrow. But we do this with a very humble approach. And we really, really appreciate all the hard work, all our subcontractors and manufacturers, and also members of the press in conveying our message to the readers, because we are all in here to get more boaters on the water. But going for the next level is going to be something interesting. What would be, or how great wouldn't it be, if the next generations of Axopars could be anything between 10, 20 to 30% more fuel efficient? How great wouldn't it be if we were having an availability to drive an Axopar anywhere around the world? Things to come for the future. Now, it's my pleasure to start talking about the cool boy stuff, the Brabus gear. So, Conte, if you join me up on the stage, and let's get the shindy going.
Welcome, everybody. Welcome to those who are back here and have been with us before. Welcome to those who are new. I'm excited to welcome you here at the Axopar and, of course, Brabus Marine display. And also, I would like to extend a bit of a greeting to Petros Michalidakis and the team of Boat Düsseldorf. Mm-hmm. I don't know, Petros, if you're here. I don't think so, but this is being streamed live on the internet, so we'll see it eventually.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I know it's been rough. The last 3 years changed all of us, and especially for Boat Düsseldorf, which is the best boat show around the world. I think we can both say that.
Yeah, for sure.
We are really, really grateful to be back here and kick it off. Also, I have to say personally, part of our business is always, a core part of our business is the interaction with people, with the press, with fans, with customers, with everybody out there. And to me, I'm very happy to be back on this giant trading floor. Yeah, the trade show really is.
For sure.
Now, before we get it started on Brabus Marine, let's jump straight into a cool video that comprises everything Brabus has to offer. Do we need to start it? Here we go. Bye. Just a quick overview, and before we start into the Brabus part, I have a bit of housekeeping to do. I know, and I've been told, that we have a few spaces left on the, normally I would say annual, but now it's kind of, it's a new old thing, yep. It's a new old stock. Now, on the Brabus HQ press tour that we are doing, it's happening on Wednesday the 25th from 1 p.m. to 5 p.m., and there's still spaces left, so if you guys are up for seeing Brabus HQ, it's about a 20-minute car ride away. Sign up. Who do we sign up with? We sign up with Evan. Okay.
Yeah.
We sign up with you, the usual.
If you get the chance, I would say this is an opportunity that you should take, because being able to dig deep into what Brabus is actually doing will open eyes. So it's a spectacular trip. You're going to be learning a lot if you find the time. And we urge you to, or if you can arrange, so that you would, we would be loving to having you for the trip.
Exactly. Now let's dive right in. Janne presented a lot of information already. I'm pressing the button. Janne presented a lot of information already, so I'm going to try to keep it short and sweet, because we've got this beauty to unveil. And I can tell you, it's absolutely fantastic. I think green is the order of the day. Anyway, Brabus, a family-owned company, 45 years in the making. We celebrated our 45th anniversary in 2022. And I'm really happy that the last 2 years didn't only bring a lot of changes, but they also, in our case, in Axopar's case, brought a lot of innovation and pushing forward, both in the digital space as well as in the product space. Every single product that we make has to adhere to a simple standard. Brabus product approvals are pretty easy. They take only 1 second. Because either we walk in, same for you, you walk onto our display, you see a Brabus car, a boat, a motorcycle for the first time, and either you've got this, the 1 second wow effect. In German, we would say Boah, or it's kind of bad for marketing, so we call it the 1 second wow effect. Which means you see the product, you recognize that it's a Brabus product, you fall in love with it, and you buy it. And the interesting thing about that is actually that it's not a given that we can transfer this from a car to a boat. If you would, for example, take a mono, one of our nice wheels, monoblock M, 23-inch, and you would screw it, would screw four of them on an Axopar boat, that doesn't make it a Brabus boat. I think it would be quite a bad design transfer. And so working on boats, we've now been working with Janne, you and your team, for the last, I think we started 8 years ago.
Yeah.
It's been quite the ride, and I can tell you guys, when we put out the first Shadow 800 at Düsseldorf, right here at Düsseldorf Boat Show 2018,
yeah,
I did not expect us to be here today. And I'm very glad it went the way it went, and we found a very, very good long-time partner with the Axopar team. So thank you guys, a lot of you here. I needed to say that. I think it's... Yeah. That is absolutely appropriate. So either it's 1 second wow or it's not.
In the case of the boats that we have for you today, it's that. Here's a quick look at the first launch. The Brabus X Joby Water Sports Accessories Collection is now in its third year. We're launching the third collection together. It's been a great ride, and we've been working with the guys from Joby now for over 3 years. So I'm very, very happy to announce that it's continuing, and we're upgrading and designing new pieces every single year. It's a journey that we discovered when we published the first boats. Fans came to us and said...
And it actually fits very well into the philosophy of Axopar, the adventure company, but I would also say Brabus is more of a lifestyle, maybe, when we talk about the Shadow 300. That is, to me, the perfect day boat, just going out and having fun and being able to combine it with the Joby product. Match made in heaven.
Exactly. Let's move on. The first boat that we want to present is the new Brabus Shadow 300 in Quantum White. It is the same boat that you find here on display to our left, but in a new color scheme that you will see in the water in the next season, called Quantum White. It is an absolutely stunning boat with a completely new gel coat white, exclusively offered for the Brabus Shadow 300. You can see it looks quite nice. It's the smallest member of our family. It's the sportiest member of the family, and I think it came out spectacular. The layout is the one you already know. Mm-hmm. And of course, you will find more information on that in the press kit. Now let's move on and talk about green. The Shadow 900 has been the flagship of our fleet for some time. The first iteration, Shadow 800 in 2018 and 2019. The second iteration, the Shadow 900, based on the Axopar 37 Gen 2 from 2020 onwards. And we've added colors, variants, we've played around with it a lot over time. And each time we did a new version, we tried to make it a version that hasn't existed before. Of course, the signature boat in our lineup is and will always be the Brabus Shadow 900 Black Ops. A Brabus car can be any color, as you know, as long as it's black. And that carries over to a lot of the boats. What makes it special is that it's a painted boat. And so was the second iteration, which took a more, let's say, elegant take on the 900, which was the deep blue.
Yep.
This year, we're taking a step further with the stealth green. Mm-hmm. It's a very unusual color combination, I can tell you. But it's one that I discovered yesterday when I saw it for the very first time here. Mm-hmm. Works exceptionally well. It is still the Shadow 900. What's new is the signature green painted exterior color, the graphics in the front. Of course, the interior color that you immediately see sunrise is the upholstery color we choose, which looks absolutely fascinating. And it's also the first signature edition that we publish with matte satin finish carbon fiber, which gives it a lot more sporty look than all of the versions we've done before. But we've got the boat right here, so let's move on. It's offered in the usual three variants. We've got the cross cabin for all year round use. It's a bit more closed. We've got the Suntop, a typical summer fun boat. And of course, we've got our Spider version that doesn't have any roof structure at all if you want to have a racier and even sportier boat. But before we unveil it, I want to present to you another product that comes with it. We've now been working with Panerai for multiple years, and I have Fabian Klose here from Panerai. Fabian, can I come up? Please welcome him, Fabian Klose, Panerai. Thank you, Fabian, for coming along.
Thank you, Fabian.
Now, maybe you can come over. We have been starting to do watches together almost 3 years ago, and it's been a fascinating journey. because we discovered that the way it happened is I met a customer, he said to me, you have to talk to Panda. I said, why? Because they're just as crazy as you. Okay, then I have to meet him. And after one breakfast in Geneva, that was that. We started making watches together. One of them I have on my wrist, and that's the one we're launching today. So Fabian, after the Black Ops, after the Blue Shadow, after the experience, this is the fourth iteration of the Panerai X Brabus collaboration. Tell us more about the Verde Militare edition.
Yeah, all right. So thanks for having me, first of all. I'm super proud to be here today. And as you can see, this is the fourth generation, as Konstantin already mentioned, of our Panerai Submersible Brabus Verde Militare edition. As you can see here, we really focused on the green color for this timepiece, and in a couple of moments, it will definitely make sense as soon as we unveil the boat. We definitely wanted to also catch up on this thing that Konstantin already mentioned, which is the Brabus 1 second wow effect. And this is something you can clearly see on that watch. You have to take only 1 second at it, and you know it's a Brabus product, of course, co-developed with Panerai. What is super special for this watch, or for the movement especially, it's the first automatic skeletonized movement completely created and crafted by the Panerai manufacturer in Neuchâtel. The watch is limited on a 200 pieces limited edition worldwide, and it comes in a 47mm Carbotech case. Carbotech is a composite material which was first used in the watchmaking industry by Panerai, and we are super proud that we found a partner like Brabus where it really makes sense to have this partnership. And yeah.
Because we wanted, if I can add to that, we wanted to work with Panerai, but as in each and every one of our product, 1 second wow means we can't just put a label on it.
Exactly.
If we do something, we have to do it right. This took us in the first edition, the Black Ops, it took us about 12 to 24 months of development, depending on how you count it.
A couple of months.
We came up with a new movement, we share material, Carbotech, it's skeleton, so I always say you can see inside the hood of a car, just like seeing inside the hood of a car. It's a fascinating product that goes on its fourth journey.
Yeah, and actually you're the first one to wear it, so lucky you.
But it's gonna be, we're gonna put the watch on display. I'll take it off right after the press conference for you to see.
Yeah, I will be here a couple of more days, so in case there is any question from your side, in order to hold the presentation as short as possible, I will be around, just come over and approach you.
Beautiful movement, micro rotor, 3 days power reserve, polarized date window. It's got a lot of cool techie features, exactly matching the boats of the cars, and that's what we set out to do. Fabian, thank you very much for being here. Team Panerai is going to be around for the whole boat show, so if you want to look at Panerai watches, they have everything, not just the Brabus lineup, but also a few others. Moving on, it's time. Thank you, Fabian.
Thank you.
It's time to unveil what's the third iteration of our flagship product after the Black Ops.
Yeah. Looking forward for it.
After the Black Ops, after the Deep Blue.
Yeah.
Now, the order of the day is Stealth Green.
Stealth Green.
Are we ready to unveil the boat?
Let's go ahead.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the Brabus Shadow 900 Stealth Green Signature Edition. Gentlemen, thank you very much for attending our press conference.
Thank you for coming. It was our pleasure hosting you and wish to see you here many days going forward. Any questions, we will always be here for you. Thank you so much.
It's your honor.
Das war jetzt die Premiere der Shadow 900 Stealth Screen, Bravos 300 White. Vielen Dank, dass Sie dabei waren und wir gehen jetzt gleich schon weiter mit der TL vom Nimbus-Stand. Vielen Dank, bis gleich.